गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव. आई एम अनिल भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल हिसुआ. वेलकम बैक टू अवर ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर वन, दैट इज ग्रोइंग प्लांट्स. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चंस, दैट इज गिव शॉर्ट आंसर्स नंबर बी. From exercise number B, give short answers. So let's start the discussion of question answer. So question number one, define germination. So class, we had already discussed about germination, that the change of seed into seedling, the change of seed into seedling is called germination. Okay. Now comes the next question. What are the necessary conditions for seeds to germinate? So here they are asking about necessary conditions, which is very important, which is very necessary for a seed to germinate. So the answer is, a seed needs proper amount of air, warmth and water for the process of germination or to germinate into a seedling. Now comes the third question. What is the role of cotyledons in the growth of a seedling? So we had already discussed that cotyledons means fleshy part of the seed which contains food for the baby plant. Fleshy part of the seed which contains food for the baby plant. Okay. So here, cotyledons contain food, and by using this food, the seed will grow into a seedling. So cotyledons provide food and energy to the seed for the growth into a seedling. Okay class. Now comes the next question. What is vegetative reproduction? The answer is, the plants grow from the different body parts of the mother plant. The process in which new plants grow from the different parts of the mother plant is called vegetative reproduction. Again, I am repeating, the process in which a new plant will grow from different part or different body part of the mother plant for different part of the mother plant, like from the root, sweet potato, beetroot, carrot, from the stem or underground, from the stem, rose, mehdi, from underground stem, onion, ginger, garlic, potato. So this is how from the body of a mother plant, new plants will grow. Now comes the next question, number 5. How does soil affect the growth of plants? We had already discussed about this topic. Now again let's discuss this topic about soil. We all know that different plants need different type of minerals and different amount of water to grow well. So the soil must support the plant to grow. And different type of soil have different type of quality. Rice plant need a lot of water. So the soil must present in the rice crop field. The soil has the capacity, must have the capacity to absorb a lot of water, to maintain a lot of moisture in the field. So clay and loamy soil is good for the rice. So this is how different plants need different type of soil for the proper growth and development. So class, I hope you are able to understand why different plants need different type of soil. If any problem, ask me class, I will help you. Have a great day. Be safe at home. Thank you.